Hey guys, what's up? It's Emily. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Tonight, I'm going to be taking you through my nighttime skincare routine. Let's just get right into it. The first thing I do is I put on this headband. Jean-Luc doesn't really like when I wear this headband because I wore it when I played Joan Crawford in a music video that we did, and I used this headband during like the no wire hangers scene, and I also wore this robe, so I think it's a little triggering. I think when I'm just wearing it, really it's cute. It really just gets all of my hair out of my face. So there's a few steps in this routine that I do every night, and there's a few steps that I do not do every night, so I will be sure to be clear about what those are. The first step is cleansing. I use this Kale and Green Tea Spinach Vitamin Superfood Cleanser from Youth to the People. I feel like this is just such a gentle cleanser. It's also vegan, which is great, and I just feel like a lot of people generally recommend this. It really like gets in and cleans my skin without it being too harsh. And I've been using this now for probably like about a year, and I never want to stop. It's so good, so yeah. I do just like half a pump. That's all you need. It really goes a long way here. I'm really only wearing a little concealer under my eyes and around my mouth and some mascara, so I don't really feel the need to double cleanse. It's apparently very important to pat your face and not wipe it, so do that. This next step is something that I don't typically do every day. I probably do it once a week, and that's dermaplaning. I mainly use this for my lip and just little peach fuzz business happening around here. It's great if you have sideburns you're trying to get rid of. So yeah, it's very like gentle on the skin, and I feel like it's so much better than waxing your face. Wax is not good. I used to wax my lip once, probably every other week, and sometimes it would take layers of skin off and make me bleed. I remember I was actually recently on set. I waxed my lip right before and I had a cut here, and it just like was really hard to cover up and kind of looked like a pimple on it. It was sad. And then I'm not feeling a super amount of fuzz on my cheek, so I'm not really gonna go in for it. But yeah, dermaplaning is also just great for exfoliating your skin too. It'll take off quite a bit of like dead skin, so just careful, don't get too close to your eyebrows. And then speaking of brows, this is another step that I don't do every night, but I do it more than dermaplaning, which is just tweezing my eyebrows and cleaning them up. And then I also just will trim my brow here. Very subtly. Especially on the ends, they get really long, and so I just kind of have to keep up with it. This might not be something that you have to do, but I just kind of like to keep everything clean, copacetic. Now I'm gonna move on to a sheet mask. This is Olive Collagen Essence Mask. I do this about once a week, and I just find that it's really hydrating and just makes my skin have that extra boost. I always feel really, really refreshed too after I put one of these on, so. Okay, I'll see you in 10 minutes. Okay, let's take her off. And after I take it off, I just kind of like to press it into the skin a little bit more. I always have a lot of trouble taking off my mascara, so just kind of using this to very, very gently get any excess makeup off, but really try not to wipe, more of a dab. And then I just kind of let that dry for like a few moments. Should be very if you were to just kind of look at this as a regular night where you're not doing all this fancy stuff, you would just go from cleanser to this next product, which is the Mario Badescu Rose Water. I love this product. I have been using it for probably, I don't know, like 5 or 6 years. I use it as setting spray. I use it every morning, every night as part of my routine before my toner. It just makes me feel very refreshed. And then again, just kind of fan the face, let everything sink in. Next is this Art Refreshing Toner. I went on a trip where I had to fly last year for a week, and this is technically too big to travel with, so I said, I will just leave it at home. It's 1 week, whatever, like, I'll be fine. And I saw such a difference in my skin. This toner is so moisturizing. It has a lot of essential oils in it, like I think Hawaiian sandalwood and stuff like that. I wish I had a full list here, but I will link it obviously with everything else down below so you can check it out. But I literally cannot, this is such a staple in my skincare regimen. I apply it with my hands, so I just do like a little drizzle on my palm and I rub together, and then we just rub it on the face. Bring everything down to the neck too. Everyone says it, just reiterating. Every product that you put on your face should also go on your neck, if not also your chest and maybe even your shoulders, because your shoulders get a lot of sun in the summer especially, so taking care of just this whole area I think is important. So this next step is also one of those steps that I don't do every night. I actually have three options that I alternate every third night. The first option is using none of these products. The second option is this exfoliator, this Polish Choice exfoliator. I also apply this with my hands in the same way that I just applied the toner. And the third option is Polish Choice Retinol. These two products from Polish Choice are amazing. Do not use them at the same time on the same day. And when you're using retinol especially, introduce it to your skincare regimen really slowly. People say start once a week. It will dry out your skin a little bit at first. Take a break for a few days from it and then come back to it. I'm at the point now, like I said, I use it probably twice a week since I alternate every 3 days. And that seems to work for me. I don't feel the need to use it more than that. There are some people that use it every day. I think that's a lot. I do notice, especially if I am trying to clear up an area where I just had a breakout or something like that, where there's a dark patch of skin or a discolored patch of skin, this really, really does clear it up within a night's sleep after putting it on. So I just do a little pump and put my hands together. I like to really get my forehead because that's where I have the most wrinkles coming in. The next step, which is an every night step for me, is rosehip seed oil. I went to Australia to visit my friend and I met his friend. And I thought this young man was 22 years old. His skin was amazing, it was glowing. I said, like, what is your secret? What do you use? And he said, rosehip oil, like anything with rosehip. And then I found out later that he was 33. I swear by anything with rosehip in it since then. I just kind of do like a little drop on my forehead and then two on my cheeks, and then I rub it in with my hands. I also really love The Ordinary because I think that they have good products and they are affordable. I used to use like Basha and it was 6-7 times the price that this is, and I feel like this is honestly better. So I really recommend incorporating rosehip. This is technically rosehip seed oil, but anything rosehip into your skincare regimen. And then just do a little hyaluronic acid, also from The Ordinary. This is also a step I do every night. Just the three drops. I go really hard with my skincare at night rather than in the morning because I just feel like it gives time for the products to sink into your face rather than do all of this work just to like go into the day and put makeup on and get your face dirty. So I take my skincare more seriously at night. So because tonight is a retinol night, I also pair with this Sunday Riley 5 Stars Retinol Eye Serum. And on nights where I don't use that, I use the Summer Fridays Vitamin C Peptide Eye Cream, which is also fantastic. I use this in the morning as well. But since today is a retinol day, I will be using my retinol eye cream. I kind of like to do a little dollop and then gently tap it through the rest of my eye. And then I also do my lid. Next, I'm going to do another fan favorite, which is the Laneige Lip Sleeping Mask. I do vanilla. I also wear this a lot when I'm not about to go to sleep. And then I'm gonna take my Tatcha Dewy Skin Cream, which is my new favorite moisturizer. If you're a little more oily, this might not be the moisturizer for you. If you're more oily, I recommend this Ultra Repair cream from First Aid Beauty. Also a tried and true product. I find that this works for oily skin and dry skin, whereas the Dewy Skin Cream is dewy, so it's a little bit heavier. Every 3 nights or so, we'll mix a drop of frankincense essential oil into it. So I just kind of take like a little bit, put it on my palm, like that much. And then I just get one drop, there it is. Rub it together on my hands first. The frankincense just also smells so sweet and like really makes me like calm. We just put a lot of product on our face, so in order to make sure it all kind of sets in and I don't look like, as my friends call me, grease lightning, or like I just drizzled pizza oil all over my face, I use this guasha tool to get it all in there. I saw somewhere that you're supposed to start this guasha tool at the back of your neck because it activates your lymphatic drainage system. I am not a doctor or a scientist, so I don't know if that's true, but I've seen it a few places, so I figure why not do that. Start with the neck. Anytime you're doing guasha, there's so many different ways I think that you could do this, but you want to just make sure that you're going in an upwards motion and never down because you want to lift everything. So I start with my neck and I just use this edge here. And then I go in side of my face under my cheekbone first with just, again, the softer edge. I'm gonna do 10 of these. And then I take the smaller side face up and we'll kind of go in the same area here. My jaw is in between these two. I also do 10 here. And then I move up to the cheek. Again, just the straight edge here. And I also do 10. A lot of times the blood will rush to my face. That's normal. And then we do the other side. Then I go in with my forehead. When I was doing my cheeks and even my neck, not really afraid to get in there and make a statement, so to speak, but with my forehead, because I don't know, like my brain is right there, I'm just a little more gentle with it. And I use like the longer straight edge part and I just go up. I don't use as much force as my cheeks. That about wraps it up. Thank you so much for watching. I'll have everything linked down below, and if you have any questions about anything, feel free to comment. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next video.